Aging, the one thing most of us wish the scientists would figure out how to stop already. Until that breakthrough happens, we'll just stay young at heart, right? At the end of the day, advancements in modern medicine have helped with our quest to live longer and prevent chronic disease. Still, there are factors that affect aging, which are simply unavoidable, such as time, genetics, and cellular mutations. Luckily, there are also factors which are within our control. Things like exposure to the sun, exposure to environmental pollutants, alcohol consumption, smoking, and nutrition. But feeling and seeing the physical toll age takes on our bodies is ultimately inevitable. Things slow down and our bodies just do not function as they used to. All this has led to the supplementation of essential and non-essential nutrients as a way to help slow down the aging process, to become a large area of research, and an even larger industry. And that's what we'll focus on in this video, the 7 supplements which have been shown by research to be of use in our quest to slow down aging. First up is an essential water-soluble vitamin commonly found in fruits and veggies, such as oranges, grapefruit, red and green bell peppers, and broccoli. It's the ever-popular vitamin C. To understand how vitamin C helps fight aging, you must first learn about something called photoaging. This is simply a term for damage the sun does to your skin. That's right, the sun contributes to much of the physical signs of visible aging. It's responsible for a great deal of oxidative stress in our bodies, which is when something called reactive oxygen species, or ROS, are too plentiful in the body. Too many of them, and our bodily functions are negatively impacted. But our vitamin C is an antioxidant, and antioxidants are super helpful in scavenging these ROS guys and removing them from the body. This is thought to be the reason why vitamin C has a great deal of anti-aging effects. When used topically, it has a range of positive effects against skin damage and aging. It works not only to protect against this photoaging, but also to reverse signs of aging. Vitamin C also works closely with collagen, an important protein that provides our skin with structure, to increase its production, stabilize its fibers, and to decrease its degradation. In addition, it decreases melanin, which can reduce the look of age spots caused by the sun. Vitamin C also works synergistically with vitamin E to protect against oxidative damage. So how much vitamin C do you need? To maintain normal bodily processes, the recommended daily allowance is 90 milligrams per day for adult men and 75 milligrams per day for adult women. Speaking of vitamin E, it's the next supplement on our list. This essential fat-soluble vitamin is one we need to consume through food sources. Vitamin E is naturally found in foods such as walnuts, sunflower seeds, peanuts, and almonds. As mentioned, vitamin E is also an antioxidant, meaning it too can help protect against oxidative stress. Like vitamin C, it has shown efficacy in treating photo-aged skin and reversing skin damage. In fact, one of the most biologically active forms of vitamin E is alpha-tocopherol. This just so happens to be something which is reduced when we are exposed to UV light, which can ultimately lead to skin damage. Thankfully, we've learned that by taking vitamin E, either orally or topically, we can replenish this depletion and help protect our skin against these signs of aging. On top of helping with aesthetic signs of aging, it's been associated with preventing premature aging, with mice studies showing vitamin E to have a neuroprotective effect. Humans aren't mice, so we'll hold out for more human studies on this one. But it is a promising finding nonetheless, and may be a signal of things to come, such as the use of vitamin E in protecting against age-related neurodegenerative disorders. So how much vitamin E do you need? The recommended daily allowance for adults is roughly 15 milligrams per day. Next up is another useful antioxidant for anti-aging efforts called coenzyme Q10. While not essential like vitamin C and E, its quantities in the body do deplete over time, which is worrisome because of its important role in producing energy as well as in the aging process. In fact, recent research has shown that coenzyme Q10 may play a role in many age-related chronic diseases, including helping with cardiovascular disease prevention and an ability to protect the brain, possibly against degenerative diseases like Alzheimer's and Parkinson's. Thus, as this antioxidant depletes due to aging, we likely become prone to these chronic diseases, which is why researchers are working hard to determine whether coenzyme Q10 supplementation can actually work to prevent the onset of these diseases. So how much coenzyme Q10 do you need? Well, due to it being naturally produced by the body, there is no currently established recommended daily allowance. When taken as a supplement for overall health, however, the typical dosage is about 100 milligrams per day. Next on our list is quercetin, a plant-derived compound classified as a bioflavonoid, Well known for its anti-allergenic, anti-inflammatory, and anti-carcinogenic effects due to its ability to act as an antioxidant and scavenge-free radicals. Quercetin can be found in many fruits and veggies, such as grapes, blueberries, cherries, onions, and broccoli, and continues to be studied in supplement form for its anti-aging effects. One such study, back in 2016, sought to show the effects of topically applied quercetin as an anti-aging nutraceutical. The results of the study showed its ability to increase dermal thickness, improve the appearance of wrinkles on the face, and improve the elasticity of the skin. Alongside quercetin's topical application for skin health, it has also been found effective for the prevention and treatment of various neurodegenerative disorders. While the exact mechanism by which it does so is unknown, it is thought that its activity as an antioxidant may play a role. In fact, quercetin is thought to be 6 times more effective as an antioxidant than vitamin C. Finally, it has also been shown to lengthen the lifespan in various animal models. As always, we prefer human studies, but do draw some hope from the animal ones. And so, while the mechanism of action is still being elucidated for these anti-aging processes, and while we wait for even more studies to prove its benefits and safety in humans, especially when taken as a supplement instead of in food, quercetin does look promising for both aesthetic and physical health. So how much quercetin do you need? Because quality and active ingredients in supplements may vary widely from maker to maker, optimal doses of quercetin have not been established for any condition. Common oral dosages for adults are 500 milligrams twice a day, but people have also used lower dosages. Next up, we have another plant-derived compound, a flavanol by the name of Epicatechin. It can be found in various food sources, such as green tea, apples, berries, and grapes. But if you're looking for the ultimate source of Epicatechin, look no further than cocoa beans. They actually led researchers to study this flavanol for its longevity effects in the first place. The story goes, because residents on an island outside of Panama, where cocoa beans are widely consumed, were far less affected by chronic disease and showed a longer lifespan than those living in Panama. Scientists hypothesized the cocoa beans may have something to do with it. Since then, numerous studies on cocoa beans and chocolates were performed, in an attempt to explain their seemingly mysterious anti-aging effects. While the exact mechanism is not known, researchers have shown that it has the ability to improve blood vessel function, insulin sensitivity, blood pressure, and inflammation, all of which could be associated with the aging process. They predict that Epicatechins may play a role in it all, and as excited as we are, we'd still like to see more research on the matter. So, how much Epicatechin do you need? The studies we mentioned looked at various dosages, all with various benefits and results. A daily dose between 200 to 300 milligrams appears to be enough to elicit the effects and benefits mentioned. However, more studies in humans need to be conducted for a true clinical dose to be identified. Next on our list is yet another plant-derived molecule called resveratrol. Next time you hear about the myriad of health benefits of red wine being touted on your local news, think of this otherwise not mentioned natural phenol, which rests inside the bottle. Resveratrol has been shown to be effective in the prevention of diabetes, certain cancers, and Alzheimer's disease, all of which are associated with the aging process. Before you start celebrating about fusing red wine and anti-aging, it's important to note that while many successful animal trials have shown resveratrol's ability to extend the lifespan and prevent chronic disease, human studies are still on their way. Though some short-term studies with small sample sizes have shown efficacy, and though experts agree that it does have potential, in our opinion, more research and better designed studies are necessary to confirm its effectiveness. So, how much resveratrol do you need? The dosages in most supplements are typically much lower than the amounts beneficial in research. Most supplements contain 250 to 500 milligrams. Until more high-quality research is done, a dosage for human longevity and anti-aging is not currently known. Finally, we have another more familiar-sounding supplement, zinc, an essential nutrient that we must get from food sources. How important is zinc? Let's just say it's necessary for 300 different enzymatic processes, and over 2,000 transcription factors in gene regulation rely on zinc to work. Yeah, zinc's kind of a big deal. When we are deficient in zinc, our bodies can experience growth retardation, immune dysfunction, oxidative stress, and eye-related disease, among other things. Much like many of the supplements we mentioned thus far, zinc is an antioxidant. For this reason, it is being used to help decrease chronic diseases such as atherosclerosis, cancer, and neurodegenerative diseases. All of these are associated with the aging process, and thus zinc is considered to be yet another antioxidant that may work to help the aging process in adults. Also, like many of the supplements we mentioned, more clinical trials with humans are necessary to determine how well zinc works as an anti-aging supplement and at which dose it is effective. Well, that's that. Those are the chosen ones. We hope this video helped you understand the aging process a little better. In closing, anti-aging factors you can control include sun exposure, pollution, alcohol consumption, smoking, and nutrition. Supplements can work alongside a proper diet and provide otherwise missing anti-aging nutrients in a more concentrated manner. Most of the supplements we find that are useful in the anti-aging process are antioxidants. They work to scavenge free radicals and reduce oxidative stress in the body. Positive findings from animal studies do not necessarily translate to these supplements having a positive effect in humans, but they do open the door for well-designed human trials to be conducted. And most importantly, please speak with your doctor before making major adjustments to your diet and/or lifestyle. Some of these supplements may interact with other medications you may be taking, and some may bring about side effects not mentioned in this video. Lastly, please help this video never get old by hitting like, subscribe, and the notification button below. Thanks for watching!